Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. It's an early one here. Good sleep, so we're working. Let's get on with it. We're doing the corner of Kent Street and Lower Lune Street. So if you look at the end of the street, there's the Ferris Lighthouse. Which, you know, it's one of those actually tall structures here in Fleetwood. There's one lighthouse there, and then there's another lighthouse further down, and you line the two up to get into the channel. That was the third one in the channel itself. But that's pretty much sunk now. Because the sands have changed. So what used to be kind of a firm layer of sand in the Victorian era is no longer. So it has sunk. Oh dear. So the problem with drawing with ink, it doesn't always dry fast enough. You're supposed to avoid it because it's on the edge. I wish to smear. Well, once it's happened, there's not a lot you can do about it. If you're doing your commission work, you just start again. Because especially on the edge like that, you can just really, you should start on the right side and you should start on the right side and work to the left, but that would help you avoid. And then you've got windows above those windows. And the cats have decided they're hungry. But they don't get fed till like 7 o'clock. It's 20 to 5. Just trying it on because they can. Fortunately, it risks waking up the my youngest, because I think my eldest is awake. My eldest keeps weird hours. He's slept, but he's awake now. And this detail here, really, it's the reason why I liked this. And the thing is, I tried to get a more up-to-date view this particular angle. If you go to current day, you can't see those at all. What's interesting about this particular shot that I completely forgot about is at the end of the street here. There's the Roro ferry that used to go to Ireland and the Isle of Man at different times. They don't anymore. It's one of the reasons why the third lighthouse sunk, because it stopped dredging the channel. One of the reasons why they moved it is because there is now like a a dual carriageway all the way up to the next port up, which is he should. They changed before they finished building the road, but essentially, it's allowed them to travel faster. And our roads weren't really suitable for, for the amount of lorries that used to have to come down. It would have made sense if it was like a railway and then loaded onto airships, but no, it was all anyway. You can see it there. I went to yeah, I should have done the cards. I looked back yesterday. But yeah, I knew people who worked at the port when it was it's now just kind of wasteland. There is a council proposal to use it as a community hub in some way. I don't understand. They've not actually said what, they've just, oh, well, it could be a community hub. So we'll just put that on, we'll have to do this side. everything done and sent off yesterday, so I had a look at the gallery exhibition, and the only way I can really apply for it is if I make a brand new painting by tomorrow. Don't really have anything at home. This problem with being an artist. I don't really have anything I'm satisfied with. Because it's a big national gallery, has open watercolour, which means I'd have to drop everything apart from the pen and a lot of the drawings I did. The a lot of the paintings I did last year also had the acrylic markers on. And the only one I can think of that I did without, I think it has to be from last year as well. Yeah, it has to be from last year as well. The only one I did, no, even that one, even that commission that I did with it. So yeah, I haven't actually got anything you're allowed to do. You're not allowed to do kind of mixed media, which is what it kind of counts as if you which is possible that I could wrong with this drawing is that it kind of feels out of scale. Like, even though they're not those are the same size, it feels like, yeah, it just feels like they're short. It's right, but it just it doesn't feel it. Those doors are all brownish. The rest are white. Possibility is that I could be doing, if I want to try for it, I need to act pretty quickly. it's not completely unreasonable to make a painting in terms of time and scale, but I can't guarantee it would one be a masterpiece and two, I don't really know. I don't really have a kind of a scene in mind. It's one of the problems. This one isn't that kind of. This one's a light yellow. Shadows. The entire side of this building's in shadow. But we can kind of assume that they are from the colour. Another layer of shadows there. And then there's some shadows here between those. Yeah. Adding these shadows in, not even done the paper. Second light on the same colour. Same that. And yeah, it wouldn't mean like doing an average paint. It would mean doing, you know, it's the sort of thing that you enter after like a year's worth of drawing, same thing over and over again, and picking your best. Anyway, enough for worrying about that. I like this upper colour a bit more than the lower one. Once again, the problem with not mixing enough paint. Let's just try to even it out a little bit. Same on this side. Even though it's in shadow. Just darkening, there we go. little bit. And it just feels a bit more red. Anyway, thanks for watching. Enough waffling. I'll be back tomorrow. See you then. Bye.